are back on the 10 count. I'm Steve Kim, joined by Michael Montero and Doug Fisher. We preview July 29th at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York. It's showtime for junior welterweight placement. Mikey Garcia takes on the problem, Adrian Broner. Doug, I think it's very simple. Al Haymon, the PBC, and whoever's on that side of the fence, they see one star that is shooting and ascending, and I think they're telling Adrian Broner, excuse the term, piss or get off the pot.
Absolutely. I think it became evident with the Adrian Granados fight, a fight that I thought could have gone either way. I think Adrian Broner was lucky that fight took place in his hometown of Cincinnati, Ohio. He got the benefit, the slight benefit of the doubt, in a legitimately close fight. I'm not throwing shade on the fact that Broner was the winner in that fight. I'm just saying the underdog, the visiting guy, did not get the benefit of the doubt in any of those close rounds. But let's face it, Adrian Granados is not a world beater. He's really a gatekeeper, what we call in boxing, a gatekeeper. And Broner didn't crash through those gates. He snuck through. And so that lets you know where he is in the boxing world. And I think if you're pushing Broner, you want to send him a message. If you still believe in him, you want to send him a message like, man, you better train like your career depends on it. And they know
does.
They put him in with Mikey Garcia.
Does.
He better train. He don't want to get knocked out, right? But they also know that if he's just finished, if he's plateaued, if he's just screwed around too much and he's not serious enough to actually be a world-class professional boxer, Garcia is going to expose that, and then they just jump on the Garcia bandwagon.
Mike, you know what worries me about Broner? This fight's at 140, and talking to Mikey Garcia and his brother, there are penalty clauses, but here's the reality. Last year he fought Theophane, didn't make weight, lost his WBA title. He had a sliding scale for Granados where it went from 140 to 142 to 144. Are we sure he could make junior welterweight in year 2017?
We're not sure. The one thing, you know, you mentioned it's Mikey Garcia, right, Doug? It's the best opponent he's ever fought. He has to take this camp seriously.
That's a good point, yeah.
And Broner knows that. On paper, this is a very close fight because if you look at even Garcia's career, he's only fought above 130, I think, twice.
Yes. One fight at lightweight.
One fight at lightweight.
The last
hasn't
one.
Fought the best opponents in the world, especially the last few years. He hasn't fought anybody on the level of Adrian Broner skill-wise.
Right.
So on paper, this is a very, very close, almost pick-em fight, in my opinion.
I agree.
If you look at the trajectory of the careers, I think we're probably going to see a few competitive early rounds, and Garcia is going to chop him down.
Well, that's why Garcia is the odds favorite, because of the
career. And those odds makers know what they're doing.
They do, because of the career trajectory, but also because of the character of both fighters. They look at Garcia, and they see a mature professional.
He's reliable.
He's reliable.
He's reliable.
They look at Adrian Broner, and they see Bandcamp.
Yeah.
They see TMZ.
You know.
Right?
Yeah.
Let me make a case for Broner, though. Garcia has won titles at 26, 30, and 35, never really planted his flag. He had one fight at 35 against a very small Dejan Zlatikinen.
Almost tailor-made like style.
Tailor-made
as
size.
As were most of his signature victories against Orlando Salido, against Rocky Martinez.
Right. Who dropped him? Didn't he drop
him? Did he?
No,
I think Rocky
no, it wasn't him. It was someone else. I think it was Wanma. I think Wanma had a flash knockdown.
Did he have a flash?
Yeah, it was one of those fights. He had a flash knockdown. I think it may have been Rocky, in fact. You're right. But Adrian Broner is a big guy. He was miscast as a welterweight, but he's a bigger guy naturally than Broner. Also, I've said about Mikey Garcia, he is the modern-day Juan Manuel Marquez. If you pitch fastballs in the middle of the plate, he will time you off the back foot. Broner himself is a counterpuncher.
Right.
So the question then becomes, who says tag, you're it? Who initiates the action?
Do you remember when a young Juan Manuel Marquez fought Freddie Norwood?
Yeah, and he stunk it out and he won.
Nothing happened. And he lost.
A lot of nothing.
You had two counterpunches.
Right, a lot of nothing happened.
Exactly.
So when people say that, that Mikey's going to blow him out.
Oh, no.
Two things.
Agree.
The motivation for Broner has got to be there. And number two, stylistically and from a physical standpoint, Broner does pose some difficulties.
And there's certain talent attributes that Broner brings to this fight that I think are going to trouble Garcia. First and foremost, hand speed.
Yeah.
Speed and reflexes. He has not fought a lot of speed demons.
And Broner
I'm talking
can
about
fight
he
on the
being,
inside.
Being Garcia. He has not fought a lot of speed demons. In fact, if Broner was more
at home or comfortable with stick and move strategy, I might even favor him in this fight, because I don't think Garcia is somebody who likes to go on the hunt. He's not somebody who cuts the ring off on his opponent. He likes them to bring the fight to him, and he's brilliant on the inside. If but maybe Broner has that ability if he really wants to. Just stick and move a little bit. And if he can do that, it's going to be a difficult night for Garcia.
The one defining moment of Adrian Broner's career is a loss against Maidana. I was there ringside. What does Maidana do? He lets it go. He doesn't care about technique, being fundamentally sound. He lets his hands go hard, heavy, and often. That ain't Mikey Garcia. Mikey is really a guy, he's like a sniper. Sniper's not like a machine gun guy who just throws bullets, just fires the gun. Sniper lines
that's
you up.
That's a good point.
Lines you up and wait for that perfect
shot. He's not a physical fighter. He's not like Sean Porter. He's not like Maidana. And Maidana and Porter are not just volume punchers. They're kind of awkward.
Yeah,
very awkward.
They throw punches off the wrong foot, and they're coming when you think they're going, and vice versa.
This is when we go back to the character of the fighters. And I just think, again, I think the first six rounds of this, Broner might be up 4-2, it might be 3-3, but the character comes into play, and Garcia is the more disciplined fighter, and Broner has a tendency sometimes to stand flat-footed in the pocket and try to trade with guys. And that's where I think Garcia can hit him with something hard and change this fight.
Yeah, I think Broner does that too much. And the reason we know that is because we know he can take a good shot.
Right.
It's because he's standing there taking good shots.
Has
from
he
guys
faced
like
a punch
Porter
like
and Maidana. He's faced power that Garcia has. He hasn't faced a power puncher with the accuracy.
Exactly.
And
the straight punches.
Yes,
right?
that Mikey brings.
So it should be an intriguing matchup. It is the problem against Mikey Garcia, July 29th. It's on Showtime from the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. On behalf of Doug Fisher and Michael Montero, this is Steve Kim saying, till the next round, goodbye, everybody.